No.
Don't even think about it.
No one wants to talk to you.
Oh, really? Everyone else said no, didn't they? I'm the only one that'll talk to you. Oh well, this is the Agate Creek camp area. We're here to find some gems for the girls. By gems, I mean agates, thunder eggs, or whatever else you might find here.
What's an agate?
What's an agate, I hear you ask? Yeah. This is what an agate looks like.
Welcome to Agate Creek camping. So there's a little self-check-in honesty station on your way in the gate. Fill the form out, put your cash in, away you go. It's also right near a mine, which we're not going to be here when they're doing it, but they are blasting in the next couple of days.
Alright, quick pan around. Having our coffees before we go off and look at the fossicking area.
Here's a little bit of what we're looking for that Pee-wee found under the car last night.
Well, while I get these guys psyched to be back on camera, grab your picks and buckets and let's go fossicking.
We dig, 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 you're mine the whole day through. To dig, 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 is what we like to do.
So we're on Hannigan's Hill, fossicking for agates. It's a little bit scary because it's a very, very steep hill.
We are digging for crystals.
We're digging for agates.
Agates.
This is just a river wash.
No, Daddy, stop. You just dug a good red one up.
Yeah, I'm looking for the big ones that are buried.
I found one.
We have got a ton of crystals. We've found like 2,020.
Like bone-coloured kind of one. Because inside it is usually like something like this.
I can't really see
it. So, I think we're going to check out a new place. But if not, catch you later.
Getting pocketfuls, but there's nothing big. I'm sick of finding the little ones. I want to get a big fella. I don't like my chances. I'm just going to sneak down to this next corner before I call it and go back for a drink.
Let's go!
We set ourselves up down the bottom of the camping area next to the creek. Toilet and shower block right there, probably 150 metres away. Donkey showers, beautiful hot water.
Great pressure.
Great pressure, she says.
Better than the caravan parks that you pay $50 a night for. That pressure up there.
We've made the executive decision to try and go to Cobbold Gorge tomorrow. We were due to go the day after, but it is bloody hot here and there ain't nothing to do except fossick.
And we've had so much luck at that.
And the girls hate fossicking. Mainly they hate sitting in the car while we fossick. So, we're going to try and get in there tomorrow for a swim.
There's huge potential. You can see massive dig sites out there with people who are really giving it a red hot crack. We, as usual, don't have the equipment. We went out there with a shovel and a bucket, but it looks like people really get into it with, what are they called? The
picks
to get into the faces of the hills out there. But we gave it a good go and we've got some little gems. We weren't here for the money, we're just here for a good time.
Thanks for having us, Agate Creek. Everyone have fun?
Yoo-hoo!
Found some little gems. No luck on the big fella. Next up, Cobbold Gorge. Got ourselves an ensuite site so the missus can shave her legs.
Woo!
Yeah, they're a bit airy.
Shut up.
How's your father? Anyway, 40 minute drive down this lovely dirt track to get there. We'll pick you up when we know what's going on. Welcome to Cobbold Gorge. First thing the girls do.
And then I'm going swimming. Yeah. In the hot tub. I'm going in the hot tub.
This pool is amazing. It's the bestest pool I've seen in the world.
First activity to tick off for the day, bushwalking. We're doing the shortest one at 2 kilometres long.
Mom, look at
Dell's
me.
Track. We have to look for the red markers. Who can see one?
Right there.
Right there. Oh, it's right there, Dad. Robin Hood Station, on which we are based currently, is 330,000 acres.
Daddy?
That's a lot of lawn to mow. That completes the bushwalking part of this journey. Now we just follow the road back to Cobbold Village. Peyton's coming home strong. She can feel the pool water on her body.
My heart's beating.
She saw the herd of cows. Pooped herself, she did. Some of the 16,000 head of cattle they run on this property. Done and dusted. 2Ks knocked over for the day. You want to do it again tomorrow?
No.
Mila?
No.
Alright, guess that was our only bushwalker trip. Now show me your spinnies. Belly flop. The kids are enjoying some sun at the infinity pool after our walk this morning. I think they're freezing because the water ain't that warm. Peyton, is it warm?
You don't want to go in.
She is covered in goosebumps and Mila is shivering under a hot towel. Little Mila's going to bed for the last time as a 3-year-old. Tomorrow she wakes up being 4. What do you want for breakfast?
Cereal.
What do you want to do tomorrow?
Go to the pool. And then, after the pool, I'm going to go see the helicopter!
You want to go watch it take off?
Yeah!
Let me read it to you?
No, Mama.
Happy 4th birthday, Mila Grace. We hope today is everything and more. You are our sassy, determined little devil child and we love watching you grow
That's
each day.
Mommy.
Never change. We love you, Mummy, Daddy, Sissy and Jacko.
Wow. They shine. Like... Yeah,
it's a pretty dress.
She's That's from like... Mummy? No, this is mine. That one's from Mummy. Thank you, Mommy. Ta-da!
Wow.
Mila gets the pool to herself for her birthday swim.
Do you want to come for a swim in the big pool with Mum? Alright.
Head to the chopper! We'll be right back.
What did you think of that?
Good. That was my best present out in the world.
Best present in the world?
I had the butterflies the whole trip.
Yeah,
you were pretty... But it was amazing.
Pee-wee was pretty quiet with me. Did you talk, Mila?
Did
you
talk?
Really.
What did you see? What did you see out there? Cows.
What else did we see? We saw the big dam where the gold mine is. Yeah, and we saw the gorge.
How did you enjoy it, Mum?
Oh, that was fantastic.
Not gonna lie, my heart went to my throat. My fear of heights kicked in big time as we took off.
Yeah, I could see the awkward wave out the window.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear. Happy birthday to you. Habib.
Hooray.
Habib. Habib.
Habib.
Habib. Habib. Blow it out. Harder. Woo!
Happy birthday, Mimi.
Happy birthday, Dada.
She's gonna kill ya.
Oh, you bitch. I call you up in the middle of the night. Been bothered by dreams, ain't feeling alright. You give me comfort, say just give it some time. By the end of our talk, I'm feeling just fine. You and I will always know where we belong. This ain't no ordinary love we got going on.
Take off. Heading north towards some hot springs. Did you girls enjoy the campground?
Yeah!
What was your favourite part?
The aeroplane. I mean the helicopter.
Helicopter for Peyton?
Cake!
Mila loved her birthday cake. She got to celebrate a birthday with a helicopter ride, a swim in a pool, and birthday cake. One lucky four-year-old. Mum's just ducked off to get us some coffees for the road. Then we're heading north towards some hot springs. You'll have to wait for next time to check that one out. We'll leave you with one last look around Cobbold Gorge.
Yay!
Have a good one.
Folks,
have a look at these pelicans trying to make a show.
Well, while I psych these guys up to be back on camera, grab your pit. Well, while I get... Oh, I'm in the fucking...
Anyway, guys, grab your picks, your buckets, and let's go looking. Next up, Cobbold Gorge.
Cobbold.
Hi, I'm Mila, and I have a guest for you. I'm turning 4, and it's my birthday today.
Have a look at, wait, what do I say?
Have a look at these pelicans trying to make a show.